Harrowby Hall, 20th of March, around 9 p.m. Mr. Richard Harrowby invites a group of his closest friends to a dinner party. These include a lawyer, a police officer, a judge, an actor, Felicia Robinson. Whether it was spite or an act of proposed friendship, nobody will ever know. Because 2 hours later, the guests were all dead. The strangest part is, the autopsy at the scene showed no signs of death. Everyone was mysteriously dead, except from our illustrious host and our actor. Dear Felicia, after everything, I hope to host a dinner that will help rekindle our friendship. I will provide a meaningful incentive on your arrival. Yours, Richard Harrowby. Presuming the murder is one of those two, why would they leave the other alive?
You heard what the police dude said. It was 4 heart attacks. All we need to do for our paychecks is talk to the survivors. You're taking this way too seriously.
Detective Summers never the one to take things seriously.
What makes you think that?
You're literally eating out of the evidence bowl as we speak. No, you don't. Have you drunk any of that?
Of course not. I'm serious. Look, I was going to, but it tastes awful. My stomach is still doing backflips, but these biscuits, these are the posh stuff.
Vintage Chardonnay. Someone's trying to show off. Let's go talk to them.
All right, detective, be professional this time. We don't want a repeat of the time when you tried to interview the train driver. Mr. Richard Harrowby, my name is Ollie Brooks, and this is my superior officer, Detective Summers.
Oh, but please, call me Charlie.
Don't step on that! Aconitum napellus, more commonly known as hemlock. It's very rare.
Could it cause heart attacks if ingested?
The most it can cause... a case of the runs. Listen, I told the last police officers, I'm not saying anything more without my lawyer present. All I know is they all had heart attacks at the same time. It had nothing to do with me.
Mr. Harrowby, please. This is an official investigation, and your compliance will make things a lot easier for all of us. Now, can you tell us what happened on that evening?
The evening started at 7:30. But of course, our actor friend didn't show up until 8:15, and that wasn't even the worst of it. She kept bringing up my past, especially my ex-wife.
So, Rich, how's the business? I heard you had a good season last year, and after the case too.
Yes, we are gradually on the up.
I wonder how, with this recession and all.
What are you trying to say?
I'm just saying, is everything up to date with, I don't know, your taxes?
That's all I'm saying without my lawyer.
What did you cook again?
Is this really necessary?
My partner works in mysterious ways.
Steak Diane with the tartar sauce and mixed vegetables.
I just wanted to know why it was called Steak Diane.
That will be all. We'll be in touch. What was all about the steak, Diane?
Just a hunch, and don't call me Diane.
You just said that to make the joke, didn't you?
We've got to keep a low profile. Get investigating whilst Felicia's away.
You think this suits me?
Put that away. You're tampering with evidence.
Did the key unlock the door again? Oh, where's my keys?
Miss Felicia Robinson, we're here to ask you about the murder of the guests at Harrowby Hall, 20th of March.
I won't use that colour on you. It's bad for your bone structure. Try blues or greens. It'll bring out your eyes.
Miss Felicia, may I ask you about your recollection of events?
The evening started at 7:30, but I just spent too much time choosing my outfit, of course.
Of course Mr. Rich didn't like that. He kept trying to tell me how I wasn't wanted after the case.
The case?
Mr. Harrowby's ex-wife. She died, didn't she?
It was suicide. The judge ruled it a suicide, but of course Mr. H still thinks it was me.
I'm surprised you showed up after the case.
You know how it went. The judge said not guilty. We'll leave it there. I kept talking about why his wife chose me over all people, then we had food.
How much did you drink?
Not much. I had like half a glass. Actually, I had a terrible stomach ache. I think I ate too much of the food. It stopped me from going to rehearsal as well. Oh, I'm going to be so behind. Saying that, tickets are still available.
So now you admit it was 4 heart attacks at the same time?
Were you asleep when we were in the police training? Oh, of course you were. Do you remember what our teacher said about trusting your instincts?
Yeah, my instincts are telling me to get food. My stomach's still doing backflips.
Maybe we could go and get some drinks?
Oh, I'm sorry, was I not supposed to say that?
On the contrary, I think we need to talk to the host again. There's something I need to clear up.
So is that a yes?
Mr. Harrowby, I need to ask you one more thing.
Would you like a drink? I've got a plane to catch soon.
Aconitum napalis.
Yes, the purple Aranthus. What of it?
That was the first clue. Aconitum napalis is not Aranthus, nor it is hemlock, as you suggested earlier. Search it up, detective.
My God.
Aconitum napalis is the Latin name for
monkshood, a rare plant found in mountainous areas. Can cause dizziness, stomachache, and if ingested in large amounts, can cause
fatal heart attacks.
This proves nothing. You're throwing serious accusations around with no evidence. I could sue!
And heart attacks leave no trace. Well done, Mr. Harrowby. You sure know your plans.
So what? Say out of pure coincidence I did do it. What next? How did it get in their system?
I'll let my colleague explain this.
Did you know there's a flower in China that turns your spit blue?
All right, I'll explain. It was all thanks to my colleague here.
Have you drunk any of that?
I was going to, but it tastes awful.
Vintage Chardonnay. Someone's trying to show off.
Vintage Chardonnay. Expensive. But that's not the reason you chose Chardonnay, did you? Because what do you know about steak?
It's chewy, hard and salty. Oh my God! Salty steak!
So the more they had to drink, the more poison they ingested.
Oh yes, that sounds perfectly plausible. But why would I keep one person alive, hmm? Why would I kill all my friends and leave one alone?
Well, that was something you didn't count on, was it? Because Felicia is known for one thing, and that's being talkative. So she talked instead of drinking. And when she did take a sip...
Actually, I had a terrible stomachache. I think I had too much of the food. Stopped me from going to rehearsal as well.
So she drank, but not enough to kill her. Just like Detective Summers here. Taking a sip of the lace drink. Feeling slightly off, but overall, perfectly fine.
So that's it, is it? You accuse Mr. Harrowby of murder in the dining hall with the monk's hood. But why do you think I would kill all of my friends?
Because they are not your friends, are they? Because 3 months ago, there was a case. Your case.
A lawyer who defended the innocent. A police officer who laughed at the whole affair. And an actor who was too talkative to kill.
Because these friends of yours were all present for the trial in which you wrongly accused Felicia for murdering your wife. When instead, you were just jealous that she was having an affair and she couldn't handle everything at once, could she?
Mr. Harrowby, I'm so sorry.
It was all my fault. If I hadn't let her go, if I hadn't been so persistent.
Oh, please, don't pull the emotional card with us. You wanted to murder your friends and you tried to kill us too.
I what?
Monkshood, Let's add it to the list of charges. Murder of two. Attempted murder of Felicia. Attempted murder of two police officers. How long would that be, Charlie?
At least 30 years. Nothing those expensive lawyers can do for you now, huh?
I just wanted justice for my wife.
Don't we all, Mr. Harrowby? Don't we all?